Hello, friends, and welcome to this crochet tutorial where I will show you how to make the bunny drawstring bag. In this video, I will show you how to do the bag separately with a little secret up here to make it so that the drawstring closes as well as it does. We have our little bunny ears that stand up alone, no wires, nothing, all done by crochet. We have safety eyes for our bunny and a triangle sewn on nose. Come join me. Let's make this bunny drawstring bag together. Let's begin. The materials and tools that we're going to use to make this bunny drawstring bag. Here I have loops and threads, impeccable brights. This is the color of bright sky blue. I like this color too, by the way. This is some red heart bright pink. This will be for the nose. We have some black, and we have some chunky white with variegated colors in it. The crochet hook is a 4.5 millimeter, a tapestry needle, pair of scissors, and here I have some safety eyes that are a size 28 millimeter. It has a glitter backing that you can put on it, and the safety mechanism that goes on the inside of the safety eye. When we make the bag, we need the bottom half to be doubled yarn. So to make it easier to have doubled yarn, let's go ahead and take the band off the skein. You have an outside yarn. If I can find the end of it, here it is. And then you have one from the center pull. This is going to be fun. Anyway, once you find the center pull, we want to join both of these together to start on the bottom of our bag. So you go ahead and find your center pull, and I'm going to go ahead and find my center pull, which is usually like digging for treasure, and I'll be with you in just a minute. So now that I have ample amount out, here we have our two strands. So let's start off with a magic circle. I like to untwist my tail, and that first chain, I like to make it kind of tight, leaving your first loop a little long. Let's start with a half double crochet, and we're going to place six half double crochets onto our magic circle. Here's two, three, four, five, and six. I know the camera is showing my blue yarn. Kind of looks purplish, but it's actually a real pretty turquoise color. So with your finger and thumb, pinch those two stitches at the end and pull your circle closed. Do not cut your tail. We'll weave those in a few rows. So right here into your first stitch, we're going to place two half double crochets. This will be an increase so that we can have a flat bottom. So here's one and two in the same stitch. Into the next stitch and the next five, two per stitch. So we have a total of 12 half double crochets in this row. Now, if you feel comfortable enough, I know I didn't say it in the materials. Let's see, where is my stitch marker? I always have a stitch marker available, and sometimes it likes to run away on me. So here's our first stitch, right back here. Okay, so we have one, two, three, and four. Continue on around. If you place stitches where your stitch marker is, you've added too many. We need to stop right here and then count. Make sure you have 12. Please pause your video and I'll meet you there. Continuing on. Now please note that this is a spiral, but every time we change the amounts, that will be beginning of a new row. So let's remove our stitch marker. In our next stitch, one half double crochet, replace the stitch marker on the right side if you're right-handed, on the left side if you're left-handed. Okay, so we have one. Now in the next stitch, we're going to place two half double crochets. This will be our increase. So the repeat for this row will be one in one stitch, into the next stitch, two. So we've done our two, so into the next stitch, one half double crochet. The next stitch, two half double crochets. One and two. Continue on with this repeat until you get to the end. And please remember, you will stop. You will have two in this last stitch here. If you go where your stitch marker is, your count was off somewhere. Okay, so one and then two, one and then two. Continue around, I'll meet you there. Please pause your video. So let's enlarge our loop and take our hook out and flip it over. We like to secure our magic tail. If you were to cut this right here where it's at, all your stitching will come undone. So we want to secure it to make sure that it does not come undone. So thread your needle, and you see the direction it's coming out, so we want to continue around. And what I like to do is to go behind the stitches one more time. I do know that there is a version of a double magic circle beginning, but I usually prefer to do just the one, because every project that I do is a little bit different. It doesn't always have the need for a double magic circle. Okay, so we went behind those stitches. Now what we're going to do is come up a row and go behind those stitches. Okay, pull it through. Now to lock in what we've just done, go over this end stitch and under the rest. We're going to go back the same way we came. If you go through the same hole without going over, all this will come right out. So go over that one and then pull it through. Okay, and stretch it so that it'll work itself in. And then we can cut our magic circle tail right here. Okay, and that'll lock all that in place without any worry of it coming undone. Continuing on, let's place our hook back into our loop. Remove our stitch marker. Now this row, we're going to do two singles and then one double. So for this stitch, the next stitch over that we just took our stitch marker out on, let's do one half double crochet. That's a single one. Replace our stitch marker. The next one is a single half double crochet. So we're just placing one in there. And then the next stitch will have two. If you look at what you've are placing your two in, you'll also see that there was two from the previous row. So that way you know that every time you add a double, it'll be in with this one right here. So let's continue on. This is our repeat. One half double crochet, next stitch, one half double crochet, the next stitch, two half double crochet. So let's do that. One half double crochet, next stitch, one half double crochet. Oops. Make sure you carry your two strands with you. And then in the next stitch, two half double crochet. Okay, I'm going to encourage you to continue that all the way around. And remember, the last stitch before the stitch marker will have two half double crochets. Continue on, I'll meet you there. Please pause your video. Continuing on, let's remove our stitch marker. So for this particular round, we're going to do three single half double crochets. One, two, three, and then two in that next stitch. And you can see where we have two from the previous row and two from that previous row and two from that previous row. That'll also help you be a guide so that you'll know that you're on the right track. So let's do our first half double crochet and replace the stitch marker. I really encourage this for every row until we get up to the side. And then you'll see, you'll understand why. So here's one, the second one, and the third one. And here's our double. So we want two, one, two in the same stitch. All right. So one, 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 three single ones, and two in the next stitch. Continue this all the way around, knowing that you're going to end with a double in the stitch before the stitch marker. Continue on and I'll meet you there. Now our next row will consist of four. So I'm going to start encouraging you to go on your own, and we are going to continue on until we have a total of seven singles and a double. So please do each row. You got number four this row, number five, number six, and number seven. When you're completed number seven, it'll probably be about this big, which will be about 6 or 7 inches across, and that will be the base of our bag. So continue on, and I'll meet you there. Okay, One, two, three, four, two. One, two, three, four, two. And then when you complete this row, five. One, two, three, four, five, two. Okay? Please pause your video. This will take a few minutes, and I'll meet you there. Now, in case yours was curling up a little, stretch it out. Okay? I know, there's a secret to everything around here, huh? All right, so let's move on to our next row. Let's take out our stitch marker. Place one half double crochet into the next stitch. Now, to replace our stitch marker, I would like for you to go around the stitch, not up here, but around the stitch, because we're going to be counting it by rows now. Okay, one half double crochet all the way around. No adding two, one per stitch. We're going to start on the sides. That's why I said one per stitch. So let's start doing that. I'll meet you here at the end of the row. Please pause your video. There is 54 half double crochets in this row. Now, if your right side of your work is on the inside, let's curl it so that it's on the outside of your work, so that the inside will be the wrong side of your stitch. Now, here with this stitch marker, this is row one of the side. We want to do a completion of seven rows for the side. So we have one. We're at the end of row one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. When you've completed seven rows, keeping the thread or the yarn doubled through this also, I will meet you there. This will take a little bit longer than what we did here, but seven rows, 54 stitches, you don't have to count them. So please pause your video, and I'll see you in a few minutes. Got a nice little side here, don't we? All right, so where we stop at, you see I'm not directly above it. What I want to be is, see our doubles? I want to be up here, okay? What the pattern that you have here is like a hexagon. So I would like for the decreasing to start above these doubles down here. These were increases. So now this row, we're going to start decreasing. So I'm going to take my stitch marker out. Well, first let me show you here. One, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. And here, we're right here. We're still doing our spiral. So let me bring my camera up in close, and I'll show you how to decrease in this round. So the first stitch of this particular row will be a decrease. So to do a decrease, yarn over like you're doing a half double crochet. We're going to go into the next stitch and draw up a loop. Okay, we're not done yet. So yarn over again and into the second stitch and pull up a loop. Okay, you have one, two, three, four, five sets of the double yarn on our hook. So yarn over, aim your hook down, and bring it through all of those loops. And what we have done is we have one stitch here on top, so we've eliminated one stitch for this particular set of this row. Now we're going to go ahead and replace our stitch marker into that first stitch right here on the side. Okay, so now we're going to do 7 half double crochets into the next stitch, just 1 single. So we're going to do 7 half double crochets over the next 7 stitches. And we're keeping our yarn double. We're not going to be double the whole way. There is a secret, and I'll show it to you here in a few minutes. Let me see if I got 7 here. Okay, so here's our double. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So for the repeat of this row, it's going to be decrease over 2 stitches and then 7 singles. So let's do the decrease again. So yarn over. Now remember, I'm doing it slow, so it may seem a little awkward as you watching me do it. So yarn over, draw up a loop from that stitch, yarn over, and draw up a loop from the second stitch. Okay, and then yarn over, aim your hook down, and bring it through all of those loops on your hook. And that's our decrease. Now, let's do 7 half double crochets. Okay, so continue this around, knowing at the end of this row, your last stitch will be 1 half double crochet in the stitch before the stitch marker. Okay, so that'll be the last of the 7 half double crochets. So continue around, I'll meet you there. Please pause your video. So after this row, you can start to see it curl in just a little. That's what we're trying to get it to do. So here we are at our stitch marker again. We're going to start off this row with a decrease. So yarn over, insert into the first stitch, yarn over, and into the second stitch. You'll see that it does cover over the top of that previous decrease. So yarn over through all of those loops on the hook and replace your stitch marker. And this time we're going to do 6 half double crochets and then do our decrease. I'm going to encourage you to do the 6 and then the 5. Don't get ahead of me. Stop after you've completed row 5 because we will be making changes there. And I'll meet you there. We're just going to do the 2 rows off video. So please pause your video. So after we've completed the decrease with 5 half double crochets, what I'd like for you to do is to take one of your yarns and cut it. The rest of the rows will be done with 1 strand for the thinness that needed to pull the drawstring closed at the top. So I removed my stitch marker. Now this time we're going to be crocheting over this tail. So into the first stitch here, 1 half double crochet. I encourage you to replace that stitch marker into the body of this. This will indicate what row we're on. Whoops, pulled it out by accident, didn't I? I was trying to turn it around. So 1 half double crochet. It's going to seem funny this first row because you're going from 2 strands to 1, but we can do this. So let's go ahead and go around. And what we're going to do is we're going to complete a total of 6 rows of the 1 strand just around in circles. Okay, so go ahead and do that, and I'll meet you at the end in this area after 6 rows is completed to show you how to finish this row. Please pause your video. Well, this is the shape we want. You'll find out what this is all about when we gather it in and it helps pull it down. Okay, so let's go ahead and finish this row. I've completed 6. So the next stitch, single crochet, and then slip stitch. Cut your yarn with a tail long enough to weave it in with a needle. Now, what I like to do is I will bring it into the inside and I will go behind the stitches here, go through about 4 of them, then pull it through, stretch it out, go over the last one and under the rest. Come on back. Whoops, you don't want to pick up some snaggy ones there. Stretch it out. All right. Remove the stitch marker, and we are ready to move on to the next step. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to do a chain series for the drawstring pull. So with a tail on it, let's place a slip knot on our hook. And since I have made plenty of these bags, I found that if you chain 60 chains, it is long enough with extra so that we can open and close it. So I'm going to encourage you to chain 60, and I'll meet you at the end. Please pause your video. After 60 chains, leave a tail about 6 to 8 inches and pull it through. Okay, so we have our little drawstring. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to place it on our bag. Now you can see where our decreases is. In fact, the light is shadowing on the bigger stitches right here. Okay, so if we go up and find the center, okay, and then go over 2, this is where we're going to start doing our drawstring insertion between stitches. Okay, so let's go over that again. Doesn't have to be exact, but you want it to be close. So where your decreases are, go straight up, find the center, and then go over 1. Okay, and use the tail from your drawstring, pull it through. Okay, and then come over 3. Use the drawstring from the other side and pull it through. And what we're going to do is we're going to go over and under every 3rd stitch. So 1, 2, 3, we're going to insert our hook from the front to the inside and pull the chain through. Make sure you don't go into a stitch. You want to go between the stitches, because when you open and close the bag, you don't want it to snag on your stitching. Then you want to come over 1, 2, 3. Now we're going to go from the back to the front, or the inside to the outside, and pull that drawstring through. 1, 2, 3. Now we're not going to go all the way around. We're just going to go till it looks like we're here at the back. Let's see. So here. Okay. So we're going to go one more time. One, two, three. We're going to pull it back. And then over. One, two, three. And pull it forward. Then we're going to do the same thing on the other side. So here we are. One, two, three. Okay, one, two, three. In case you didn't know, on my YouTube channel, I have other bags that I have made. I have a unicorn, a bee, a frog, a chick, and let me see what else I got here. Yeah, the frog, the duck, not a chick, a duck, a bee, and a unicorn. And now we're doing the bunny. Okay. So now here you see we have the change in the row. So one, two, three. We're going to go right underneath that single crochet, pull it to the inside, and then using this top row right here, one, two, three. There we go. Now we have our two ends. We're going to bring them together. And let's place an overhand knot. Okay, now before you tighten it down, try to get it as close to the end of those chains as possible. And there we have our drawstring close. Okay, it has a little extra so you can pull on it when it's in the open position. Okay, so take note of where your front is, which for me is right here. So I'm going to place a little stitch marker, not exactly in the center front, but just enough to say, hey, this is my center front, because we're going to work in between the decreases, but it's going to be down here. Okay, so let's do our nose next, and then we can add more of the detail. So, with a short tail, let's place a slip knot on our hook, chain one, very loosely, okay? And then into the back, the little hump on there in the back, place one double crochet. Actually, half double crochet. Okay, chain one, and then turn your work. Skip this chain. In the next stitch, three half double crochets. One, two, and three. Chain one. And this is what we have so far. Let's turn our work. In the first stitch, here's our chain. In our first stitch, two half double crochet. In the next stitch, one half double crochet. And in that last stitch, it seems to want to be hidden a little, two half double crochet. Chain one. Here's what we have so far. Okay, let's turn our work. In this first stitch, two half double crochet. One, two, three. Three single half double crochets. In this last stitch, two half double crochet. Okay, now before we finish anything, let's bring out our bag and decide if this is the size triangle we need for our nose. We also have our eyes. Okay, now your eyes may not be as big as mine. Sometimes you have no other choice but to get what you get. Let's see, and I just dropped my glitter part off. I'm all thumbs today. Okay, so does that look like the right size for your nose? It looks the right size for me. So let's place our eyes back on the side here. Okay. Now, even though it looks like we have a lot of gaps, when we sew it, you won't see all those gaps. So let's leave a long tail, because that long tail will be for sewing our nose down. And then let's pull that long tail through our end right here. Okay, we have us a nice little triangle. So now here's the fun part. We want to find where the last row of increases. So here we have the V stitch here, and I have another V stitch right here. That's where the increases, the two half double crochets in one stitch. Okay, so if we count over, one, two, three, one, two, three, here's our center one, and we can go right straight up. Okay, we have seven rows. Let's see, this is the decrease row. So we want to come about right here. Okay, so that is, whoops, I want to go up one more. You want to show one row at the bottom. And let's see, one, two, three, top of the fourth, five. So we're two rows down from the seventh row of our stitch, of our side. Okay, so we can go ahead and stitch this on because we're right here in the center. Now when you stitch this on, make sure you stitch it to make it look like a triangle. This one has more of an edge, this one's kind of cornered, but you can pull that out when you stitch that down. Now the kind of stitch that I'm going to be using is just your basic like whip stitch. Okay, so let's turn this around. If you need to pin it, I encourage you to pin it. So I'm going to go down, pick up a few stitches here, and pick up a few stitches from the nose. I'm going to go straight down and come across at an angle. Okay, so when you stitch this on, if you can go straight down, you'll have less of a chance of seeing that stitch instead of at an angle. Okay, straight down. And come at an angle and pick up some more. When we get to our nose, okay, we're going to take this and stuff it up underneath so it'll be underneath in here. What I like to do is coil it around my finger like this and just bring it up underneath here. Okay, so go ahead and stitch your nose down. When you get over here, just pull that corner over just a little bit and it'll be square just like this one is here. So go ahead and do that and I'll see you after you get your nose sewn on. Don't cut the yarn yet. We're going to have one more thing to do. Now I have quite a bit of yarn left. I've finished my corner. So let's go down through the stitching to the bottom of our triangle, right here. We're going to make our little bunny have two little come down to identify the separation for the nose and whatnot. Okay. All right, just a little short little one. Now bring it to the center. And where our triangle is where we're going to end the yarn. So come on up. Let's go under these stitches here. The triangle is over the top of this section. So we'll do our weave. This time we want to do a little bit more. Make sure that it doesn't come out. So I'm going to do it probably four times. There we go. All right, let's move on to doing our eyes. Now, placing the eyes is obviously a personal preference. Some like to have them close. Some like to have them wide. I'm just going to place them on here and then decide what I need to do. Let's see. I'm going under each one of my decreases. Still got some of that plastic stuff on there. They help protect the outside when they mail them. Okay, I got one that's up higher than the other. Let's see, let's go up a little bit more. How does that look? That looks kind of cute, huh? Okay, so now to put the safety backing on, come and then take this with your thumb and your fingers. Listen for that click. Did you hear it? And it clicked. I know that there is safety eye boards that you can find on Etsy. I currently do not have one. I would like to have one. But I usually don't make amigurumi items. My daughter got me started on this for my grandchildren. Okay, so here we have our eyes on. I think it's so cute. All right, so the next thing we're going to do is add the black yarn for the little whiskers here. And then we'll be moving on to the ears. So I'm going to double my yarn when I put it in here. And I'm going to make them kind of long. So let's double the yarn. And don't make it too long, because we're going to do one side and then finish it off under the nose. Do the other side off and finish it under the nose. So that way you don't have any weaving lines that would show on the inside here. Okay, so let's load our needle up. All right, so we're going to start here under the nose. Just grab some, don't go all the way through, just grab some on the back. And to make it easier, I'm going to place a little knot on it and leave a little tail so that way if I need to use it again, I can. Okay, and then I'm going to come over following the nose, just picking up the back parts of those stitches and then coming out here on front. Okay, here's the needle right here. Whoops, I'm just hitting everything tonight, aren't I? Okay, so I want to raise it up just, no, I think right here is fine. And then I'm going to go ahead and go across and then come down and go in and then come down. And then we'll have to weave our way back. And then we can do the other side. So you decide how you want to place your whiskers in for your little rabbit here. I'm not going to make mine very long, but I'm going to go ahead and put some here, here, and here. I'll weave it under here and then come out here and do the same thing. So you decide on yours. I'm going to decide on mine. So please pause your video. And then after this, we'll do the ears. This is how my whiskers turned out. Kind of cute. So let's start our ears, and we're going to start with two strands of the yarn because we need it to be firm. So let's start with a magic circle. Whoops. And I like to untwist my tail from that circle. Okay, leave your loop large enough. And into the circle, let's place 3 half double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. And chain 1. Let's go ahead and pull our tail. Pull it snug. And we'll crochet over our tail later. Okay, so let's turn our work. In the first stitch, this is our chain. In our first stitch, 2 half double crochets. The next stitch, 1 half double crochet. And then 2 in that last stitch. I'm going to have to dig for it a little bit. So here's 1 and here's 2. Chain 1 and turn your work. Okay, so in this row, 2 half double crochets into the first stitch, 1, 2, 3 single half double crochets, 1 per stitch over the next 3 stitches. And in the last stitch, 2 half double crochet. Chain 1 and turn your work. 1 half double crochet for each stitch across. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Chain one, and let's turn our work. You will notice it's starting to curl. That's okay. Okay, so in this next row, two half double crochets in the first stitch. One over the next one, two, three, four, five stitches, one half double crochet. And then two in the last stitch. Chain one and turn your work. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. So nine half double crochets for this row, and then chain one and turn. For two more rows, nine half double crochets, chain one and turn. Complete those two rows, and then I'll meet you and we'll continue on with the making of our bunny ear. Chain one and turn your work. We're going to start decreasing in this row. So yarn over into the first stitch, yarn over and into the second stitch, do your decrease. One, two, three, four, five single half double crochets. Decrease in the last two. Chain one and turn your work. In the next row, we're going to be doing the same thing. Decrease in the first two stitches. One, two, three single half double crochets. Decrease in the last two stitches. Chain one, turn your work. You should have one, two, three, four, five. Five single half double crochets on this row. Chain one and turn. One single in the first stitch, one decrease over the next two stitches, and then two singles. I know it's it's odd, but it works. Okay, so here we have our nice little curved ear. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to go around the outside. So let's chain one, and in the middle of the half double crochet stitch, place a single crochet. A single crochet, we don't yarn over, we pull up a loop, and the yarn goes over through two loops on our hook. Then, at the top, or the bottom of the row, single crochet, single crochet in the middle of the next stitch, and single crochet into the row. Continue with this till you get down here to the end, and I'll show you how to go in the top where we started with our magic circle. So at the top, okay, here we have our magic circle right here, and here's a stitch. So we're going to single crochet into that stitch, and then over that magic circle, place one single crochet, chain one, and in the same stitch, single crochet. It makes like a little point up there. Now we're going to be stitching over our tail as well. So we're going to be stitching in the same way we did when we came up this. So now we're going to go down to here doing the same thing. So continue on till you get down to the end of the row, and I'll meet you there. And then have a nice sturdy curve. I'm excited. Okay, so let's leave some for a tail because we're going to need it to sew it onto our bag. Now for the good news. Make your second one. Don't worry, I got to do mine too. Okay, and then we'll find placement for them and sew it on. I know you're excited. Okay, I'll put a timestamp in saying where to start the video at again. Let's make our second ear. Now that we have two ears, let's line them up and sew them on. Looks like my hook wanted to get back into the show here. Yep. So let's bring out our bag and open it up, and I will show you where we're going to place our ears. Now, if you've noticed how the bag is laying, it is actually laying flat. So we are going to want to place our ears right here along the decrease of the flat. Okay, because we have our two other lines right here. So we have these two out here is where we want to place it. So when you place it on, you want to place it in at an angle. And when the drawstring closes, it'll bring the ears forward. So right there where your decrease is, you want to bring it down a little into the decrease and then a little into the single strands of the rows. So let's bring it down two rows into the decreases So you're actually doing row 5 and row 6 decreases, and then the singles up here. We're just going to do a basic stitch like we did when we put on our nose. So let's place one here and place the other one over here. Please pause your video. Okay, so I have my bunny ears sewn on. I'm going to go ahead and close the drawstring bag. And you can see how it brings them in. Kind of cute, huh? Okay, so the last thing we're going to do, I have some chunky yarn here. Now this is optional. I'm going to place little bows around my ears just to give it some color. You know, most of these are for little girls anyway. I was going to do this originally in pink, but I chose not to. So I hope you had fun doing this little project with me. I know the kids will love having this someplace to put their special treasures. Now, there is one more thing that I'm going to suggest that we do, is we need a carrying strap. And we're going to attach it here behind the ears at the top of the fifth row of the double strand. Okay, so I'm going to take two strands like we've been doing, and I'm going to chain 120. And then you will take the ends and tie it here behind the ears. And then we're done. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's chain 120. If you want the chain longer, add more to it. But let's go ahead and start that. Be sure to leave a short tail before beginning the chain for the strap. So I'd like to show you how I'm going to attach them. So right behind the ear, we have the double row and then the single row. So I'm going to pull my hook from the inside and pull one of the strand through to the inside of the bag. And then I'm going to go to the other side of the stitch and pull it through. If you pull them through the same hole, you won't be able to tie them off. So I have them here in between the two stitching. Let's go ahead and tie a nice secure square knot. Okay, we'll weave these ends in, and to do the same on the other side. I'll meet you in a minute when yours is done too. Now, I hope you had fun making the bunny bag, drawstring bag with me today. I really like it. You can use other colors. Unfortunately, the camera is not showing the true color of this bag. It looks like a purple when it's not. It's a beautiful turquoise blue. So, before I go, I would like to show you the other bags that I have made in this series. So hang on just a minute and we'll have our little demonstration of the other bags I've made. Here I have the unicorn drawstring bag. Has little flowers on the top and the unicorn horn with the curlies. I have a bee drawstring bag. This one is currently the very popular one. This is the Frog drawstring bag. Remember, I just grabbed these off the shelf too. So, and then I have the duck. So, I hope to see you again. Come check out my channel. I have plenty of crocheted videos. I have home repair videos. I have cooking videos along the lines of Arabic cooking. So, I hope to see you again sometime. So, till next time, bye-bye.